The remains of a Filipino woman who was brutally killed in Kuwait, now back home in the Philippines. Philippine authorities vowing to exhaust all efforts to bring justice to Julie B. Renara's family.
Kung sino ang may pananagutan, eh talagang pasasagutin natin. Very cooperative naman ang gobyerno ng Kuwait at inakinilusan lahat kagad.
The charred remains of the 34-year-old household worker were found in Kuwait's desert on January 22nd. The son of Renata's employer is in Kuwaiti police custody after confessing to the crime. The Philippine Department of Migrant Workers has prohibited Renata's employer from hiring another Filipino. But for Senate Migrant Workers Committee head, Senator Rafi Tulfo, a total deployment ban to Kuwait should be imposed following the gruesome crime.
Ang akin pong agad suggestion is to send a very strong message, which is total deployment ban. And then after the total deployment ban, that's the only time na we can sit down with them sa bilateral talks, pero on our terms. Meron tayong mga kondisyones na ibibigay sa kanila. Kung gusto nila yung ating OFW, dapat magpapakita sila ng mga patunay na sila ay malinis ang kanilang record, meron silang police record, and then ito pa. Ang gusto ko i-suggest is lahat ng employers sa mga high-risk countries, they have to submit a document na pumasa sila sa neuropsychiatric exam.
The National Bureau of Investigation is slated to perform an autopsy on Renata's remains. Authorities are hoping family and friends will be able to pay their last respects to Renata by Sunday. Meanwhile, Isabela's risk reduction officers say they could reach the possible location of the plane that went missing in the province this afternoon. Our correspondent Jackie Manabat now joins us live for the latest. Jackie, over to you.
Nikki, the search may be soon over as the rescuers nearest the possible site of the missing plane in Isabela in the mountains of Sierra Madre could be reached on foot around 4 in the afternoon today. However, Isabela MDRRMO clarifies that it is not yet confirmed whether the white object seen by a farmer of Barangay de Caruyan is the missing Cessna plane, but they are taking their chances.
Kung gaganda sana yung weather, sir, mas mabilis po yung paghahanap natin through ear, by ear tayo. So, ang tanging nagagawa lang po natin ngayon is by ground, by foot siya. Kaya wala pa pong nakapagsabi ngayon na bukas or mamaya makikita natin. So, it depends po. It depends sa panahon.
Divilakan MDRRMO on the ground says that barangay officials saw a white object that's approximately 4 hours away from their vantage point. And the low-lying clouds, however, covered the area immediately that the officials were not able to confirm if it is the missing plane. Ground search operations have been ongoing for days following the testimony of the farmer. But the inclement weather and the treacherous hike posed challenges to the rescuers. Some of them caught fever, others were injured. The area is 1.8 million square meters surrounded by rich vegetation and rivers. Isabela PDRRMO says these challenges will not hamper their search. They added that they are also now discounting areas outside Barangay de Caruyan. The 5th Infantry Battalion have been trekking the area to search for possible sightings. It has been 4 days since the Cessna 206 went missing, minutes after it took off from the Cagayan Domestic Airport, supposedly bound for Maconacon, a 30-minute flight. 5 passengers and a pilot were on board.
As soon as the land or ground search and rescue teams reach that, hopefully, the aircraft, what they will do is provide aid and comfort to survivors, to keep them as best as they can physically hanggang dumating po yung aerial rescue. They will keep the survivors as comfortable as possible and feed them, apply whatever medical procedure they are qualified to do habang hinihintay po yung aerial rescue.
Nikki, the Isabela PD RRMO remains optimistic that there are survivors. And as you can see here behind me, we are inside the Tactical Operations Group 2 of the Philippine Air Force. They are training force multipliers on how to go down the mountains of Sierra Madre. They are preparing for days for this aerial search. When the weather clears, they will deploy these choppers. These are two choppers here for the aerial search to that part of Sierra Madre. Nikki.
All right, thanks for that comprehensive report, Jackie. You stay safe. Live from Isabela.